Hello and greetings from Iceland. In this short update, I will be talking about the eruption and how tourists might be able to visit the volcano soon. And I will also be talking about the increased seismic activity in Iceland right now, or what we consider to be normal, although the Icelandic norm is quite abnormal sometimes when it comes to earthquakes. But we start by the volcano, and overall it's a bit like the media got a bit bored with all of this and got back to cooler topics. And lately, lava hasn't been advancing very far, so we don't expect the eruption to do more damage than it has already done. Or in its current state, the Met Office has estimated that 50% of the magma comes up from the main magma chamber at 8 to 12 kilometers depth, is left behind in the smaller magma chamber that is inflating once again, and the other half of the magma is the eruption that we see now. So what scenario awaits us this time? Since November 10th, we got 6 versions, all due to the smaller magma chamber that pressurizes after it fills up. But what we have now is an ongoing eruption, or this open vent. And one can easily assume that this open vent is preventing it from pressurizing, like it used to do before those other events. And I'm more and less in the dark here, so feel free to tell me what you think. Experts call this the learning mode, and I couldn't agree more. In fact, this whole scenario has been a learning mode for scientists. So all we can do is just to guess. But there is less guessing going on when it comes to tourists. I have good news there. The Icelandic tourist board is working on solutions to allow people to visit the volcano. But first, they need to solve issues like carpark and stuff. And this time, it would be the shortest hike so far. But during the first 3 eruptions, they kept on getting longer. And the last one was awful, because I was carrying so much camera stuff. But as for hiking up there, it is such an experience to get so close to a live volcano that I'm very glad to see if that option will open up. But there are, however, still a few obstacles not up to us to fix. Like when and if this magma chamber fills up, one of the scenarios might be yet another large outburst of magma during a short period. I think we will have to wait for this magma chamber to fill up and see how this volcano reacts this time. So it's not a good idea to book the trip just yet, but it is the time, however, to be on a lookout, and you will of course get all the information you need through my channel. It has always been a priority to cover useful information for volcano tourists, and the Blue Lagoon is already open. They have had some problems with gas pollution, at least twice, so they just evacuated until the wind blew it over. And overall, it's business as usual there. But the seismic activity in Iceland is, however, a bit more than usual now. And it's logical to assume that such chapters reveal some of the weak spots, like where will the crust give in next time. But those chapters can also send us some false alarms. And when we see the earthquake map a bit colorful, I tend to get questions in the comment section. So I want to end this by Hekla volcano today, where we had a small earthquake on top of the mountain at a very little depth. And to make this short and simple, she gives us hardly any signs while dormant. And small earthquakes like this, they are quite common actually. But the main problem is, however, that she gives us at most 30 to 60 minutes notice before an eruption starts. And we know it for a fact that Hekla has inflated way more than before the last eruption in 2000. Some even say that she might blow her hat off when she takes off next time. That is, however, uncertain, but it is a fact that if the interval between eruptions is 50 years or more, old Hekla just turns crazy and throws boulders and lava bombs tens of kilometers away. Like Hekla had little over 100 years to reload before the 1947 eruption. That eruption went on for 13 months, and I'm leaving a link to a video in color and in excellent quality despite the age. And my point with this Hekla detour is that this little earthquake there today is nothing out of the ordinary, although it was at a little depth. But is she capable of surprises? And the answer is definitely yes. And due to all these earthquakes, I have many topics that I need to cover in the next days, and plenty of footage that I have been processing recently. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.